Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are covering here question number 101 to 120. This is the part 7th of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure. Now question number 101. A complaint to a police statement made to a police that fall within exception number 8 of section 499 IPC can claim absolute privilege, qualified privilege, both absolute as well as qualified privilege, neither absolute nor qualified privilege. So here option B is correct. Here it is qualified privilege. So exception number 8 of section 499 provided a qualified privilege. So what is qualified privilege? So qualified privilege is where a person is permitted in position of authority. So position of authority, first here person having position of authority to make a statement. So second one here, he make a statement. Statement that would be a considered slander. So such statement is considered as slander. Slander and libel. Libel. If made by anyone as. So third, fourth point important here. If made by anyone else. So qualified privilege means the permit a person in position of authority or to make a statement and rely a statement would be considered slander or libel if anyone as. So if any person is getting the authority to make a statement of slander or libel, so such person is under in section, like the advocate in cross examination have authority to take some in under the judicial process to ask the question related to the such matters, so not treated as the defamation. So now option B is here. Question number 102. Under section 161 of CRPC, the investigating police officer has power to examine orally the person acquainted with fact and person acquainted with the fact and circumstance of case, including accused, does not include accused, refer to the prosecution witness only, and both B and C. So here answer is including accused. Why it is including accused here? Because in this section 161 the word used here any person. So such any person include accused. That's why here option A is correct here. Now question number 103. The investigating officer during investigation record the statement of witness under section 160 160 162 161 and 164. So here answer is 161. So 161 provide the provision that may examine the orally any person and supposing to be acquainted with the fact and circumstances. So the any person including the accused as well as witness. So section 161 provided that examination of a person by police officer. So there is an option, use word here may. So this may is the provide the power of the police officer. The police officer having capability to examine that or not. So because the evidentiary value of the section 161 is in the trial procedure is nothing as it is only the helping matter of the investigating to collect the evidence. That's why the police officer use it for the collecting the evidence in during the investigation. So now question number 104. The magistrate record the confession of an accused or a statement of witness during investigation under so here magistrate record the confession. So now under section 164 of CRPC, section 281 of CRPC, section 162 of CRPC, chapter number 13 of CRPC. So here answer is option A under section 164 of CRPC. Now we are concerned here some important facts of section 164. So 164 here, the recording of confession and statement. So first 2 points here, recording. Which thing is recording here? First one is confession and second one is statement. So second one is statement. What is confession? So confession is not clearly defined, but it is the basic topic of evidence, code of evidence. So but now in general way, the confession is a statement of accused in the reference of the offense. So it is confession here. So these 2 points here and recorded by the magistrate. So which magistrate? There is no option, there is no special provision for the magistrate who is take cognizance. Any magistrate can record the admission or confession under section 164. So here any magistrate. So such magistrate is basically metropolitan plus judicial magistrate. Judicial magistrate. So but not thus any other magistrate like executive magistrate or this magistrate. There is a provision, if such magistrate is not having the jurisdiction upon such offense, but these two magistrates like first metropolitan magistrate, second judicial magistrate can examine the accused or other witness under section 164 whether he has jurisdiction or not. And if there is a confession, the confession must be signed. But no oath, no provision of oath. Because when the magistrate regarding the confession under section 170, 164, he after the confession recording, he must the sign his and the accused. But such recording of confession without oath, if there is oath, the relevancy of the evidentiary value of the recording under section 164 is null. Now question number 105. A joint statement in several witness and recording during investigation will render these persons in as incompetent witness, will render their evidence as inadmissible, will render and render these persons as incompetent witness nor their evidence inadmissible, will render these persons as incompetible witness, competent witness, and also their evidence inadmissible. So here option B is correct. Will render these persons as incompetent nor their evidence inadmissible. Now question number 106. The statement of a witness recorded under section 161. So 161 provided, already expressed here, the statement recorded by the police officer. So in writing during investigation is signed by the person making the statement is hit by section 161 subsection 2 of 161 of CRPC, subsection 3 of 161 CRPC, subsection 1 of section 162 CRPC, subsection 2 of section 162 of CRPC. So here answer is option C, subsection 1 of subsection 162 of CRPC. So section 162 provided that here the statement to a police not to be signed signed and use of statement in evidence. In evidence. So this provision provided under section 162. It is the limitation of it. It makes the hurdles against the section 161 and examination of the witness under section 161. The police officer should not force the witness to sign upon the statement, recorded statement by the police officer. Now question number 107. The FIR is not a substantive evidence. It can be used during a trial as a corroborate the informant, the contradict the informant. Option C, both A and B. Option D, neither A nor B. So here answer is option B, both A and D. FIR is the procedure of FIR is not defined in CRPC, first of all here. And its procedure is provided under section 154 of CRPC. So FIR is not a substantive piece of evidence. First point here important. Second, it used the corroborative in informant. And second point here, it contradict the informant. Now question number 108. The FIR can be given by accused also. The FIR is given by the accused in the same can be used for corroboration of the accused, for contradict the accused as an admission if the same is non-confessional and against the accused as confession. So it is option C is correct. The FIR is given by the accused. So here FIR is given by the accused. If FIR given by the accused, the same can be used as admission. It is given as admission. Used as admission. If the same is non-confessional. If it is not confessional. Because the confession before the police is irrelevant. According to section 25 of Indian Evidence Act. So it is irrelevant. So here non-confessional statement is relevant. And it is used as evidence in FIR. Now question number 109. The statement recording during investigation under section 161 of CRPC can be used during trial. For corroborating the witness, for contradicting the witness, both A and B, and neither A nor B. So here answer is option B. Contradicting the witness. Now question number 110. If a person whose statement is recorded by the police during investigation is called as a defense witness, his previous statement before a police can be used for corroborating him, can be used for contradicting him, cannot be used for any purpose. and option D, both A and B. So here answer is option C, cannot be used for any purpose. So if the person, the statement recorded by police during investigation is called as a defense witness, if he is defense witness, his previous statement before the police is cannot be used for any purpose. Now question number 111. The section 162 of CRPC provides that the statement made by the police to a police officer during investigation and reduced and to writing shall be signed by a person making the statement. The statement made by a person to the police officer during investigation and reduced to writing may not be signed by a person making the statement. And no statement made by a person to a police officer during investigation and reduced to writing shall be signed by the person making the statement. The statement made by a person to the police officer during investigation reduced to writing shall be signed. Here important shall be signed by a person making the statement only if the police officer obtain a prior permission of the court obtaining the signature there. So here answer is option C. Means here the no statement made by the person to a police officer during investigation reduce the writing shall be signed. So the police officer record the evidence during investigation, record the statement of any person during investigation, the police officer has not authority to sign that person upon a such recorded statement by the police officer. So option C is correct here. Question number 112. The prohibition contained section 162 of CRPC shall not apply where the statement made to police during investigation is made admissible under any other provision of the code. Shall apply even where the statement made to a police officer during investigation is made admissible under any other provision of the code. Section 162 has overriding effect and may and may not apply where the statement made to a police during investigation made admissible under any other provision of this code depending on the fact and circumstance of the case, and may not apply where the statement made to a police during investigation is made admissible under any other provision of this code depending on the discretion of court. So here question is, the provision contained under section 162 of CRPC shall not apply where the statement made to a police during investigation is made admissible under any other provision of the code. If the statement recorded under section 162 and the restriction is under 160, the statement recording under section 161 during investigation by the police officer and restriction is there under section 162 not to be signed by the person, and if the person is signed by it upon the statement recorded by the police officer and such document or such statement is taken any other provision of this code, other provision of the code, so it can be admissible in that code, but in the provision of these CRPC and this code, here in this trial the evidence, if there is a signed by a recorded statement under section 161, is not admissible and it's written under 162. So option A is correct, not applicable. So this provision is not applicable any other provision of the code. So if there is any other provision of the code, so such restriction is not applicable which are provided under section 162. Question number 113. A bar created under section 162 CRPC does not apply civil proceeding under article 34 of Constitution, the proceeding under Article 226 of the Constitution, all of the above. So here answer is all of the above. I think here Article 32, but it right here 34. Okay, it's 34, but actually I think according to, because there is a writ provision, so writ in Supreme Court 32 and writ in High Court 226, so it is possible here Article 32. Okay, option D is correct, all of the above. Now question number 114, the word statement within the meaning of section 162 of CRPC means the narration, sign and gesture, both A and B, and only A, not B. So here answer is option C, both A and B. Now question number 15, which of the following is not a statement within the meaning of 162 of CRPC? The record, option A here, the record of search made by police. So here record, the signature and handwriting and thumb impression and making for the purpose of comparison. Option C here, both A and B. Option D, only A, not B. So here answer is option C, both A and B. Now question number 116, which of the following statement is or are covered under section 162? The statement made to a magistrate in the presence and hearing the police officer. Option B, the statement to a third person in the presence of police officer. Option C, the statement made to a person assisting the police in the investigation of the case. Option D, neither A nor B nor C. So here answer is option D, neither A nor B nor C. Question number 117, section 162 of CRPC apply to a statement made to a police officer during investigation by witness, by accused person, by accused who turn approver, and all of the above. So here answer is option all of the above. So section 162 apply the statement to a police officer during investigation in all these persons here, witness, accused and turn approver. So here the police officer is not forced these persons to sign upon their statement. Now question number 118, section 162 CRPC prohibited the statement for being used in evidence made in the course of inquiry, investigation, trial A and B. So it is clear here option B, investigation. Now question number 119, section 162 of CRPC apply to statements made to a police officer in the course of investigation, before investigation begin, after investigation begin, had ended, all of the above. So here answer is in the course of investigation, option B. So we can also call here during investigation. Question number 20, whether a statement was recorded in course of investigation is question of law, question of fact, mixed question of law and fact, question of law or question of fact depending on the facts and circumstance. So here answer is question of fact. So again I read here question, whether a statement was recorded, the statement was recorded. So there are two provision of statement recording in CRPC before a trial. So first one is section 161 and second one is section 164. It is recorded by police and it is recorded by magistrate. So it is the question of fact, not question of law. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, click on like button and please don't forget to subscribe our channel. Please share this video to your friends and relatives. Thank you for watching.